Lumia 950 XL is the biggest of the two new Windows 10 smartphone brothers, and at 5.7 inches, we're definitely treading into phablet territory. This bad boy is a real pocket filler, matching Sony's Xperia Z5 Premium for girth, though it's also a wee bit lighter. One-handed use might be tricky, but you do at least have a nifty half-screen mode to help out. That's fine for checking messages and so on, but some apps do lose vital functionality, such as the ability to switch tabs in Edge. Unlike most recent phones, you can actually pop the back off to access the removable battery, SIM card, and the microSD memory card slots. That back-end plate is made of plastic, which feels rather cheap compared with the glass-metal Xperia Z5 or the leathery finish of the LG G4. It's certainly not ugly, but it does lack the premium touch that you really expect at this price point. Turn it around and that massive 5.7 inch screen packs a mighty quad HD resolution, and movies look fantastic. Not just sharp, but with colours that really pop off the screen too. Contrast levels and viewing angles are also impressive, making the Lumia 950 XL a serious media monster. Sadly, the quality of the dinky rear-mounted speaker isn't quite as good. It's all too easy to smother with a finger by accident, while the output is decidedly tinny. If you're a fan of Windows Phone, you'll be right at home with Windows 10 on the Lumia 950 XL. The desktop is still filled with live tiles, which can be rearranged and resized as you like. Swipe down from the top of the screen and you'll find your notification screen, now with more shortcuts and toggles than ever before. And of course, if you swipe left from your desktop, you'll encounter an alphabetical list of all of your apps. But sadly, Windows 10 is still an unstable platform here. In just a few days of use, I saw dozens of little bugs, with videos locking up, photos glitching out in the camera album, my Maps app refusing to actually display a map, and the occasional crash. Even the notifications bar occasionally takes 2 or 3 swipes to drag down. Of course, every new OS always has issues, and we're confident that Microsoft will iron out most, if not all, of these bugs real soon, especially with help from the Insider program. As for apps, you can now download big-name apps such as Netflix, WhatsApp, Spotify, and Adobe Photoshop, with plenty of third-party solutions for missing apps. Well-known gaming titles such as Hitman Go, Crossy Road, Monument Valley, and Leo's Fortune have also finally slinked onto the platform. However, many Windows apps are still unfortunately inferior to their iOS and Android counterparts. For instance, the YouTube app is little more than a glorified web link, while the BBC's iPlayer radio app won't even let you sign in to access your favourite shows. Again, there's some serious work to be done to catch up to the competition. There's no fingerprint sensor anywhere on the Lumia 950 XL, but Microsoft's Windows Hello feature allows you to unlock the phone with your eyeballs instead. Just stare at the front-facing camera and the lens should automatically detect if you're the registered user and unlock. However, Windows Hello still struggles in the dark, often asks you to move your face closer, and generally takes longer to work than the fingerprint sensors found on rival handsets. Much more impressive is Continuum, which allows you to attach your phone to a TV or monitor and create a temporary desktop machine, which is really handy if you're always on the move and don't want to lug about a laptop. Continuum is potentially a game-changing feature, but unfortunately you do have to stump up close to an extra 100 quid for the dock to get it to work, and we don't actually have one as yet, so stay tuned for a full review coming soon. One of the few differences between the standard Lumia 950 and the Lumia 950 XL is the processor. While the Lumia 950 packs the hexa-core Snapdragon 808, the Lumia 950 XL boosts up to an octa-core Snapdragon 810, although we didn't really notice any difference in performance. Apps still load quickly and games run smoothly, with only the occasional stutter cropping up. When it comes to charging, the Lumia 950 XL uses Type-C USB, which gives you a 50% charge in just half an hour. There's also out-of-the-box support for wireless charging, as long as you stump up separately for a wireless charging pad. However, battery life will only keep you going for a full day if you're restrained, while streaming video kills the Lumia in 5 to 6 hours, which is a pretty average result. Now, Nokia and Microsoft have for a long time been market leaders when it comes to camera tech. And the Lumia 950 XL packs a 20 megapixel Zeiss lens with triple LED flash, and it's another solid snapper, producing detailed packed photos and coping admirably with a range of conditions. However, with hot competition from the likes of Sony, Samsung and Apple, the Lumia 950 XL struggles to stand out despite its funky Live-in Images effect and its very streamlined camera interface. For our full thoughts and plenty of samples, check out our Lumia 950 and Lumia 950 XL camera review live now on recombo.com/mobile, and stay tuned for a full video. Windows 10 is bursting with potential, but right now it's unfortunately a bit of a buggy mess. And while the 950 XL's Quad HD screen and solid 20 meg camera are undeniably great, you'll find rival Android hardware for the same price that's just as good. For that reason, we suggest that you hold off for now or look at something like the Moto X Force as an alternative. For the full 950 XL review and plenty of comparisons and other features, check out recombu.com/mobile.